I was privileged and honored to have joined the World Youth Day in Lisbon for the first time last month. The long walk under the scorching heat in the midst of a packed crowd have been a great challenge for many of us. But towards the end of the day, you can hear almost everybody saying, "All I need is a good shower," or "I am dying for a good shower." It feels like a good shower is all that you need to wash off all the stuff of the day. Too often, baptism is understood simply as a sacrament that can wash off all the stuff of our lives, particularly sins. Well, at some point that's true, but not only that. For indeed, there is more to baptism than just washing off all the stuff. The word baptism comes from the Greek word baptismos or baptisma, and from the Hebrew tevila, simply meaning to be immersed in the water. Immersion meaning to be soaked in the water and not just a quick dip. In the gospel, we hear of Jesus asking John to baptize him in order to fulfill the prophecy. And when Jesus had been baptized, just as he came up from the water, suddenly the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased." Jesus, God's beloved Son, immersed himself into the water. Though without sin, he immersed into the water so he can be in complete and total solidarity with us in order to redeem us from our sinful condition. And in so doing, Jesus humbled himself to share in our own humanity, that in his own self-emptying, we are able to share in his own divinity. The beloved Son of God emptied himself in order to immerse himself totally into our own human condition. And that made Jesus very much been able to somehow relate in the condition of the sick, in the condition of those who were ostracized and isolated by society. This is primarily why the waters of baptism, before you can associate it with new life, has first of all to symbolize death. Meaning, it is about the process of dying and rebirthing. For us Christians, baptism means dying to the old and sinful humanity of Adam, and being reborn into the new humanity of Christ. Jesus' baptism was a defining moment in his life. It marked a departure from the years of somehow relative anonymity, that means the hidden years, as they have sometimes been described, until the beginning of 3 years of public ministry. His baptism affected him greatly. He was revealed by the Father as being divine as well as human. But it is an important thing to note that by his own immersion, he was as well commissioned. He was commissioned to do the Father's will, and he was assured that the Father's favor would be with him throughout his ministry, in his ministry of preaching the good news, in his ministry of healing the sick, in his ministry of courageously speaking out against injustice and oppression, in his ministry of performing miracles, even with his own passion and death, death on a cross. And so in the same way, the sacrament of baptism is meant to be a defining moment in our lives too as Christians. At baptism, we are cleansed from sin through sharing in Christ's death and resurrection. The basic task for every Christian then is to live our baptized life. This means that we need to recognize that we have been chosen by God to share in the life and ministry of Jesus. Only then can God say to each and every one of us, "You too are my son, my daughter, my beloved, my favor rests on you." Therefore, baptism offers us a new identity in Christ. The gospel on the baptism of the Lord challenges us to reflect on our own baptism and its significance in our own lives. At the time when many people have abandoned the faith, it is imperative that Christians are committed to living the baptized life. Our annual pilgrimage has been blessed greatly by the dedication and commitment of our many volunteers, whether as nurses or hospitality attendants. But I think it is worth mentioning that we have been blessed evermore with the presence of our young people from the Oblate Youth Service. It is indeed very inspiring to see that young as they are, they strive to live their own baptismal calling as best they can. Saint Bernadette Sobiru, the visionary of Lourdes, who by the time of the apparition would have been much, much younger than many of us here, yet she has been chosen by the Lord and Our Lady to be an agent, an instrument, in order for God's wonders to take place. In 1858, Mary invited Bernadette to go and drink at the spring and wash herself. There was no visible spring except the river. And yet in faith, Bernadette obeyed, and she was instrumental to uncover and discover that spring that is present yet hidden. Of course, in the process, in doing that, she herself will get the dirt and the mud. So my dear brothers and sisters, in the same manner like that of Bernadette, we can uncover and discover that beautiful spring that gives life and warmth and healing and comfort to others. But in the process, in living out our own baptismal commitment, we can get the dirt and mud as well ourselves. Imperfect as we may be, unworthy as we are, we need to go and drink at the same spring and wash ourselves clean. We do not have to do great things. Saint Peter in our first reading is telling us, we do not have to be necessarily the best among the rest. We just have to do what is good. We just have to uphold what is right and true. So in our own simple and little ways, let us strive day in and day out, living out consciously and faithfully our own baptismal commitment and calling. By our own immersion into the water of baptism, we are now commissioned to simply even become God's living and loving presence in the world.